إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونسترضيه ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. الحمد لله الذي خلق الإنسان من طين لاذب ثم جعله نطفة بين الصلب والترائب وجعل منهما الأبناء والأقارب وحملهم في البر على الدواب وفي البحر على القوارب. أسأل الله تعالى أن يقينا وإياكم شر ما هو حاضر وغائب. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة يرضى بها عنا وترضيه يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم، والقلب السليم هو المشغول بلا إله إلا الله. سبحانه من تكلم علم نطقه، ومن سكت علم سره، ومن عاش فعليه رزقه، ومن مات فإليه منقلبه. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله، صلِّ اللهم وسلِّم وبارِك وزِد على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلِّم تسليمًا كثيرًا. عباد الله، إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمدٍ صلى الله عليه وسلم، وإن شر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثةٍ بدعة، وكل بدعةٍ ضلالة، وكل ضلالةٍ في النار. الحمد لله أن أكرمنا بالإسلام، ونسأل الله تعالى أن يحيينا عليه وأن يتوفنا عليه وأن يجمعنا في الفردوس الأعلى مع إمام المسلمين النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Sheikh, he started by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending his salutations upon the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He mentioned many things in the introduction. He mentioned how we are from clay and we were created, etc. He mentioned a number of things. However, in general, he mentioned the Khutbatul Haja, and shall we begin? تفضل شيخ.
أول ما أبدأ به أتقدم بخالص الشكر.
The first thing I wanted to start with is by passing on my sincere thanks
لإخواننا الذين
for the brothers who
وثقوا فينا
who trusted me
وظنوا فينا ظن خير
and had good thoughts about me
فدعونا لنتكلم عن الله وعن رسوله
who invited me to speak about Allah and His Messenger
وأسأل الله عز وجل أن يغفر لنا ولكم ما لا تعلمون
and we ask Allah to forgive us and to forgive you about that which people don't know
وكذلك أشكر إمام المسجد
and I also wanted to thank the Imam of the Masjid
وكذلك أشكر الحضور
and I also wanted to thank those who are present here
وأدعو لكم بدعاء رسول الله
and I wanted to supplicate with the supplication of the Messenger of Allah
طيبتم وطاب ممشاكم
that may you have a good life
وتبوأتم من الجنة منزلا بإذن الله تعالى
and may Allah give you high ranks in paradise
والله يا أحبابي إخواني إن أفضل ما يعيش فيه المسلم وأكبر نعمة يعيش فيها أن جعله الله من أمة النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The greatest favor upon us is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made us from the ummah, from the nation of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
موضوع اليوم.
The subject of today.
ألا وهو.
It is.
كيفية الوصول.
That how can we arrive.
إلى أن تكون ممن أحبهم الله.
How can we be of those who Allah He loves?
وهذا هو شغل المجتهدون.
And this is the thing which concerns those who strive.
وله قام القائمون.
And this is the concern of those who do.
وله بكى العابدون.
And this is the thing which the worshippers they cried over.
لأن يصلوا إلى محبة الله رب العالمين.
Such that they may arrive at the love of Allah, Lord of the worlds.
آه حبيبي وأخي في الله. لو تذوقت طعم الحب في الله رب العالمين.
Oh brothers and sisters in Islam, if only you could taste the love of Allah, the Lord of the worlds.
واختارك الله رب العالمين واصطفاك.
That Allah He has chosen you.
ليجعلك من أحبهم.
That He makes you from those who He loves.
ووصلوا إلى مقام الحب.
And that they arrived at the station of love.
الذي هو الغاية التي يسعى لها.
And which is the goal which they strive towards.
الأنبياء.
They strive towards the prophets.
والمرسلون.
And the messengers.
والناس.
And the people.
والعباد.
And the worshippers.
والأولياء.
And those who are close to Allah.
كل له غاية واحدة.
And all of them they have one common goal.
كل له هدف واحد.
All of them they have one common goal.
أن يكون ممن أحبهم الله رب العالمين.
To be of those who Allah, Lord of the world, loves.
وهذا السؤال يسأل الإنسان منا كثيرا.
And that this is a question which the human being he asks often.
كيفية الوصول.
That how can he arrive.
إلى حب الله رب العالمين.
To the love of Allah, the Lord of the world.
اسمع جيد.
Now listen carefully.
أنا ما أكلمك لأن تكون محبوبا لشخص ما.
That I am not telling you about how to become beloved to any ordinary person.
لم أكلمك لتكون محبوب. من رجل تعرفه أو لا تعرفه.
And I'm not telling you about how to be beloved to a person who you know or may not know.
لا عن ملك.
Or even about a king.
ولا عن عالم.
Or about a scholar.
ولا عن نبي ولا رسول.
Or a prophet or a messenger.
بل أكلمك كيف تصل إلى الحب. حب الله رب العالمين.
I tell you about how to arrive at the love of the of Allah, Lord of the worlds.
وقبل أن أبدأ أسألك سؤال.
And before I begin, I wanted to ask you a question.
هل أنت تحب الله؟
That do you love Allah?
Yes.
هل أنت تحب الله؟
That do you love Allah?
أنتم جوعى؟
Are you hungry?
سؤال مرة أخرى.
And I ask the question again.
هل أنتم تحبون الله؟
That do you love Allah?
نعم نحب الله.
Yes, we love Allah.
أي ورب الكعبة نحب الله.
By Allah, Lord of the Kaaba, we love Allah.
ولكن الكلام لا بد له من دليل.
However, whenever we say something, then there has to be some evidence.
Which الكلام كثير جدا.
That many many people they speak.
ما من إنسان إلا أن تحبه هل تحب الله؟
Then no.
ما من إنسان. تحبه إلا ويقول لك نعم أحب الله.
That if you meet anybody and you ask them that do you love Allah, they will say yes.
فأين أنت من الله رب العالمين.
So what is your relationship with Allah, Lord of the worlds?
تعالوا نبدأ.
That come, let's begin.
في نقاط.
Now in the following points.
حتى نصل في النهاية.
Until we arrive at the end.
إلى أن نكون ممن أحبهم الله رب العالمين.
So that we arrive to be of those who Allah, Lord of the worlds, loves.
أولى هذه الأمور.
That the first thing I wanted to mention.
أن تعرف محبوبك.
And that you must know the one you love.
أن تعرف من تحب.
And that you must know the one who you love.
أن تعرف حبيبك.
That you must know your beloved.
تعرف صفاته.
And that you must know his description.
تعرف أسماءه.
That you must know his names.
تعرف عبادته.
And you must know how to worship him.
تعرف أوامره.
And you must know his commands.
تعرف نواهيه.
And you must know his prohibitions.
أن تكون له هو.
And that this should only be for him.
أن لا تجعل مع الله في قلبك شريكا أبدا.
That you should never make a partner with Allah in your heart ever.
أن يكون قلبك هذا لو اطلعنا عليه.
That if we looked at your heart.
ما وجدنا سوى الله.
That we will only find Allah.
اسمع إلى قول الله.
And that listen to the statement of Allah.
قل إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي.
That say my living and my dying and my sacrifice and my prayer.
صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله.
Say my prayers, my sacrifice, my living and my dying are all for Allah.
لمن تصلي؟
That, to who do you pray?
ولمن تصل ولمن تتصدق؟
And that for who do you give charity?
ولمن تصوم؟
And to who do you fast
ولمن
for?
ولمن تحج؟
And who do you make pilgrimage for? Why do you eat?
لماذا تأكل؟
And why do you eat?
لماذا تتزوج؟
And why do you marry?
سألت رجل قلت له لماذا تتزوج؟
And that if I asked you why do you marry?
فتبسم الرجل.
Then the person he smiles.
كأنه يريد أن يقول لي إيه السؤال الغريب ده؟
And it's as though he wants to say what kind of strange question is this?
كأن الرجل استغرب حينما سألته لماذا تزوج؟ لماذا تتزوج؟
That it's as though a person he is surprised when I ask him the question that why do you marry?
لا تخف لماذا أنت تتزوج؟
That, don't be scared. Why do you marry?
أنتم خائفون؟
Are you scared?
لا أظن أن أزواجكم موجودين يعني.
I think your wives are here.
لا تخف أنت رجل.
No, don't be scared. You're a man.
أنت تتزوج
and that you marry
طاعة لله
as in obedience to Allah
واقتداء برسول الله
and by following the messenger of Allah.
تأكل لماذا
and why do you eat
لتتقوى على عبادة الله
to become strong such that you may worship Allah.
تحيا لماذا
and why do you live
تموت لماذا
and why do you die
تسكت لماذا
and why do you remain silent
تتكلم لماذا
and why do you speak
كل ذلك لأجل من
and all of this is for who
لأجل من
and for who
قل الله
say Allah
الله
الله
لله رب العالمين
for Allah Lord of the world.
فلا بد أن أول ما تبدأ به حتى تعرف
And the first thing you must start with is such that you know
كيفية الوصول إلى حبيبك أن تعرفه
and to know how to attain the love of Allah is to know him
فأنت تعرف على
and that you should know
أن تعبد الله تبارك وتعالى
and that you should know how to worship Allah
حق العبادة
and to worship Allah correctly
وأن تنزه الله رب العالمين عن كل شرك
and that you don't associate partners with Allah
أن تتعرف على توحيد الألوهية
and that you must know about the unity of worship
بأن الله واحد أحد
that Allah he is one
فرد صمد
that he is unique
لم يلد ولم يولد
he has no son nor does he have any father
ولم يكن له
and he doesn't have
ولم يكن له كفوا أحد
and there is no one like him
وأن تتعرف على الله رب العالمين بتوحيد الربوبية
and that you must know about Allah about the unity of his lordship
أي أن الذي رباك
and he is the one that nurtured you
وأطعمك
and he fed you
وسقاك
and he gave you drink
ورزقك
and he provided for
وخلقك
you
وخلقك
and he created you
وهو النافع والضار هو الله رب العالمين
and the one who benefits you and keeps harm away from you is Allah Lord of the worlds
وأن تتعرف على صفات محبوبك
and then you must know the description of the one you love
الواحد منكم أو أنا
One of you or me
إنما أراد أن يتزوج
that whenever he wants to marry
سأل أمه أو أخته أو خالته
that he asked his mother or his sister or his aunt
هذا في القديم
and this is a long time ago before
أما الآن نسأل الله العفو والعافية
and now the system has changed may Allah protect us Now, what color is her skin?
ما لون عينيها؟
And what color are her eyes?
أما الآن الحمد لله ربما كل شيء مكشوف وإنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون.
And nowadays everything's on views. May Allah protect us.
نسأل الله العفو والعافية.
May Allah protect us.
لابد أن تسأل عن محبوبك.
And then you must ask about the one you love.
وعمن اخترتهم.
And the one who you have chosen.
كذلك لابد أن تتعرف على صفات حبيبك وهو الله رب العالمين.
And similarly you must know the description of Allah, Lord of the worlds.
أجمل الله لنا صفاته وجمعها.
Allah he has generalized his description
في آيتين
in two verses of the Quran
الآية الأولى
and the first verse
قال
and in the,
ليس
he said,
كمثله شيء وهو
سميع
السميع البصير
and he has said there is nothing like him and he is all hearing all seeing
الآية الثانية
and the second verse
لا تدرك الأبصار وهو يدرك الأبصار
that they cannot see him and yet he sees them
نعم هذا هو الله في صفاته
And this is Allah about his descriptions. And that he has a hand, however his hand is not like our hands. And he has an eye, but it is not like our eyes. And don't be amazed, this is something which the human intellect it accepts. And you may ask that, how can I imagine a hand and I don't know it? And then what do you know?
أنت لا تعرف ما في نفسك.
And you don't even know what is within your own body.
أين عقلك؟
And where is your intellect?
من منكم رأى عقله؟
And who from you has seen his intellect?
أين العقل؟
And where is the intellect?
هل لك عقل؟
And do you have any intellect?
أخاطب من يسمعنا عن عبر الانترنت.
I'm now speaking to whoever is listening to this lecture on the internet.
يقولون عنا كيف تعبدون إلها ما رأيتموه؟ نقول نعم رأيناه في خلقه.
Now they may ask that how do you worship a God who you have not seen? We say that yes, we have seen him in his creation.
إن قالوا لنا كيف لا ترونه؟
And if they say that, how do you not see him?
هذا محبوبنا وهو الله رب العالمين.
And this is our beloved, Allah, Lord of the worlds.
قلنا لهم هل رأيتم عقولكم التي تعقلون بها؟
We say to these same people that have you seen your intellect which you think with?
هل رأوها؟
Have they seen their intellect?
رأوها أم لم يروها؟
Have they seen it or haven't they seen it?
هل رأيت عقلك؟
Have you ever seen your intellect?
عقلك موجود أم ليس موجود؟
Is your intellect present or is it absent?
فكيف هو موجود ولا ترى؟
And how is it that it is there but you don't see it?
إن قلت ليس بموجود قلت لك شكرا أنت مجنون.
If you say you don't, your intellect is not there, then we say thank you, you're crazy.
فالله رب العالمين.
So Allah, Lord of the worlds.
إذا كان هذا خلق من خلق الله فلم تراه العيون فكيف بك تريد أن ترى علام الغيوب جل جلاله؟
So if this is the intellect is something you cannot see, then how do you expect to see Allah, the one who cannot be seen?
وأنت تعرف على أسمائه.
And that you must know His names.
وتدعوه بها.
And then you must call upon Allah with His names.
ولله الأسماء الحسنى فادعوه بها.
Now Allah, He has the most beautiful name, so call Him with these beautiful names.
الأمر الثاني.
And the second thing.
من الأمور التي توصلك إلى محبة الله رب العالمين.
From the things which help you attain the love of Allah, Lord of the worlds.
أن تعرف وأن تعلم علم اليقين.
And that you should know with certainty.
أنه والله ما لك سوى الله.
That you should know that you have nobody except Allah.
والله لا يدفع عنك كرب إلا الله.
That nobody can remove a difficulty from you except Allah.
ولن ينفعك ولن يضرك ولن يكشف همك إلا الله.
That nobody can harm you or benefit you or remove your difficulty except Allah.
وأنا أقسم لك بالله.
And I swear by Allah.
لو أنك دعوت الله رب العالمين بإخلاص.
That if you call upon Allah sincerely.
حاشا لله أن يرد دعوتك أبدا.
That Allah he will never reject your supplication.
أما كانت الأمور بل والله ولو كنت عاصيا.
That even if you are sinful.
روي عن موسى عليه السلام.
And it is narrated about Musa عليه السلام.
قال يا رب.
And that he said, Oh my Lord.
ماذا تقول لعبدك الطائع؟
That what do you say to your slave who is a worshipper?
وهو راكع.
And he is in bowing.
وينادي عليك ويقول يا رب.
And he is calling upon you and saying يا رب.
يا رب.
Oh my Lord.
قال يا موسى أقول له لبيك عبدي. أقول له نعم أطلب لعبدي.
And then I will say to him that tell me what you want.
قال وماذا تقول له وهو ساجد.
And what do you say to him and he is prostrate?
قال يا موسى أقول له لبيك عبدي أطلب عبدي.
And Allah said, I say to him that I am here. Say what you want.
فقال يا رب.
And then he said, Oh my Lord.
وماذا تقول له لو قال يا رب وهو عاصي؟
And what do you say to him when he says يا رب and he is a sinner?
وهو عاصي.
And he is a sinner.
وهو صاحب خطيئة.
And he is somebody who has done a sin.
وصاحب معصية.
And he is somebody who has sinned.
لا تيأس أبدا.
And do never despair.
اسمع يا من تسمعنا.
And listen whoever is listening.
لا تيأس أبدا.
And never despair.
وليس من حق أحد.
And it is not anyone's right.
أن يقنط أحد.
And to make somebody else despair.
من رحمة الله.
From the mercy of Allah.
الذي خلقنا.
He is the one who created us.
جعل لنا الأمر.
He made things.
مفتوح.
He made things open.
فقال لنا.
And he said to us.
وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب.
That if the slave asks about me, then tell him that I am near.
هذا العبد كان على طاعة كان على معصية.
And this slave he was worshiping Allah and then he sinned.
ليست المشكلة.
And this is not the problem.
ولكن المشكلة علم هذا العبد بأن له رب.
The problem is المشكلة.
نعم المشكلة التي لا يعرفها كثير من الناس.
And the problem which many people they don't know.
أن العاصي لو نادى وقال يا رب.
That even if the sinner he calls يا رب.
قال له ربي تبارك وتعالى لبيك عبدي.
And then Allah he will say
وهو
that.
وهو على المعصية.
And Allah even then will say to the sinner that tell me what you want, I am here.
لأن الله هو أرحم بنا من أمهاتنا.
Because Allah is more merciful towards us than our own mothers.
تعال واسمع إلى.
And then listen.
إلى سيدنا الأصمعي رضي الله عنه وارضاه والأصمعي من التابعين.
Listen to Al-Asma'i and he's one of the تابعين. Al-Asma'i.
هذا رجل من التابعين.
And this was one of the scholars of the تابعين.
وكان معروف بعلمه وبزهده.
And he was known for his knowledge and for his distance from the world.
كان عند البيت الحرام.
And he was by the بيت الحرام by the كعبة.
لتعلق قلبك بالله.
No.
اسمع أي تجعل في قلبك الله رب العالمين.
And listen and make Allah in your hearts.
فكما كان من الأصمعي وهو عند الكعبة.
And this tabi'i, he was by the Kaaba.
جاء رجل من الأعراب الذين يسكنون في الصحراء.
And one of the Bedouins who lives in the desert came.
وجاء وهو يركب على ناقة له على بعير جمل.
And he came on a camel.
ووقف عند البيت.
And he came to the Kaaba.
وكان معه طفلته الصغيرة.
And he came with a young girl.
وإذا به يتكلم مع الله رب العالمين في بيت الله.
And he was calling upon Allah in the house of Allah.
وهذه هي النقطة الثالثة.
And this is the third point.
جرب الحديث مع الله.
That جرب الحديث. Speak to Allah.
كن مكثرا من الحديث مع الله رب العالمين. أكثر من الكلام مع الله رب العالمين.
Speak, try to increase in speaking with Allah.
لا تنتهي من الكلام معه.
That never stop speaking to Him.
أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قد أخبر.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he has informed us.
إن الله لا يمل حتى تملوا.
That Allah, He does not turn away from you until you turn away from Him.
أبدا بالليل والنهار.
By day and by night.
تكلم معه.
That have your connection with him, speak to him. That whenever you love somebody, that you like to speak to him a lot. And that you say to him, oh so and so, that oh so and so, I am missing you. That why don't we say to Allah, Ya Allah, we have longed to speak to you. That when you are speaking to Allah, you believe and you have a strong certainty that you are speaking to him. And that he is speaking to you. And that he is speaking. And who is speaking to you? Who?
Allah رب العالمين, الملك.
That Allah is speaking to you, the King.
الملك. Allah. الرحيم الجواد الكريم.
The most generous, the merciful.
فما كان من الأعرابي إلا وأنه بدأ الحديث مع الله.
And this Bedouin who came from the desert, he started to speak to Allah.
ورفع يده على أستار الكعبة.
And he raised his hands towards the curtains of the Kaaba.
والأصمعي يسمع.
And this Tabi'i, Asma'i, he was listening.
فإذا بالرجل يقول.
And then this Bedouin, he said.
قال اللهم.
And he said, Oh Allah.
إني جائع كما ترى. أنا جائع كما ترى.
يا الله, as you can see, I am hungry.
وابنتي جائعة كما ترى.
And also my daughter who I've brought with me, she is also hungry.
وبعيري جائعة كما ترى.
And also my camel is hungry, as you see.
وزوجتي في حاجة كما ترى.
And my wife is in need, as you can see.
ويكلم من.
And who is he speaking to?
كلم من. الله رب العالمين.
And he is speaking to Allah, Lord of the worlds.
وبدأ الأصمعي في البكاء.
And when this Tabi'i al-Asma'i, he heard this conversation, he started to cry.
إجلالا لهذا الرجل الذي يبكي مع الله ويتكلم مع الله.
Out of respect for this Bedouin who was crying and speaking to Allah.
اسمع من انتهى الكلام, كلام العربي.
And listen, the Bedouin has not finished speaking as yet.
اللهم إني جائع كما ترى.
And that, Ya Allah, I am hungry as you can see.
وابنتي جائعة كما ترى.
And my daughter is hungry as you can see.
وناقتي جائعة كما ترى.
And my camel is hungry as you can see.
وزوجتي في حاجة إلى مال كما ترى.
And my wife is in need of wealth as you can see.
اسمع.
Listen.
فماذا ترى.
And what do you think.
فيما يرى. فيما تراه لنا.
No.
فماذا ترى. أي ماذا تقضي لنا. أي ماذا يا رب العالمين يكون الفرج لا يكون إلا من عندك.
And the opening of the success is only from Allah.
فماذا ترى فيما يرى يا من يرى ولا يرى جل جلاله. أي يا ربي أنت ترانا وتعلم بأحوالنا.
The one who sees and is not seen, that he is the one who knows your condition.
فما كان من العربي إلا أنه قام من مقامه وانتفض.
And this Bedouin, he got up and it was though he felt strong. And he started to cry. And that he said, Atabi'i,
قال للرجل خذ ما أردت من مال.
And he took out from his pockets and said, take whatever you want from money.
انظر إلى الثقة في الله.
And look at the trust in Allah.
انظر إلى معية الله.
And look at Allah is with you.
فقال الأعرابي.
And the Bedouin, he said.
اسكت.
He said to him, be quiet.
هو لا يعرف أنه يتكلم مع الأصمعي العالم التابعي رضي الله عنه.
And he does not know that he's addressing a great scholar, a tabi'i.
ولكن قال له اسكت.
And he said to him, that be quiet. He said, I.
سألت من هو.
And I asked.
أقرب منك إجابة.
And I asked the one who is closer in responding to me. And then this Tabi'i al-Asma'i, he cried and he sat on the ground. And a few minutes later, and the man came, and he calling the Bedouin. And he said to him, "O Bedouin, and that your uncle has died.
وَقَدْ تَرَكَ لَكَ مَالٌ
And he has left wealth for you.
40,000 دِينَارٌ
And he has left for you 40,000 دِينَارٌ
فَبَكَى الْأَصْمَعِيُّ وَقَالَ
And al-Asma'i, he cried and he said,
بَكَى بِلِسَانِ حَالِهِ وَقَالَ
It is as though he cried from
أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَانَ
That who is the one who responds to the one in need when he calls?
وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءَ وَيَجْعَلُكُمْ خُلَفَاءَ الْأَرْضِ
And he removes the evil and he makes you inheritors of the earth. Is there a God beside Allah? And there is no ilah apart from Allah, Lord of the worlds. So the speech was with Allah, Lord of the worlds. And don't make it into an experiment. Make it something real in your life. And whenever you had a big problem or a pain or an illness, the only thing you should do is you should speak with Allah. And you should know that Allah, He is the one who hears and He sees. And He will never reject your supplication, bi-idhnillah. And the next thing, and to follow the Prophet Muhammad
sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
And that know for sure, that it's something impossible. That you should do an action that brings you closer to Allah. You can come with something which is better than that which the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam he did. So following the Prophet it is from the greatest things which it earns you the love of Allah. And where is the evidence for this? And Allah, Lord of the worlds, has said, let's say if you love Allah, then follow me. Follow me and Allah will love you and He will forgive your sins.
Allahu Akbar. فإن متابعة النبي
that following the Prophet
هي أقرب الطرق
and that it is the nearest way
إلى محبة الله رب العالمين
to the love of Allah, Lord of the worlds.
نعم. وقد أخبرنا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم
and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has informed us
بأنه قال
and that he has said
والحديث عند الإمام أحمد رضي الله عنه وأرضاه
and the hadith in the collection of Imam Ahmad
قال الله رب العالمين أي الحديث القدسي
and this is a sacred hadith
اسمع
and listen
اسمع من ربك وهو يقول
and listen to your Lord and he says
وجبت محبتي أي اسمع حقت محبتي أي وجبت محبتي
no, that my love is an obligation
وجبت محبتي لمن
for who
للمتحابين في
that those who love for my sake
والمتزاورين في
and that those who visit one another for me
والمتبازلين في أي العطاء
نعم those who spend upon one another for the sake of Allah
نعم كل تلك الأمور
all of these things
وصلك إلى محبته
all of them they take you to the love of Allah
وتلك الأمور
and these things
هي نابعة من هدي رسول الله
and these things they come from the guidance of the Prophet
النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم
so following the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
في كل ما أمر به
and in everything he commanded and everything he forbade
حتى تصل إلى حبه جل جلاله
such that you may attain the love of Allah
واسمع إلى أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم
and listen to the companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
ما الذي صبرهم على أن يتحملوا الأذى في سبيل الله لماذا
Now whoever made him himself patient to bear the difficulties
على إزاء الكفار
The companions they were patient in the face of the harm of the disbelievers in Makkah.
لماذا صبر بلال وهو يعذب؟
Then why was Bilal patient when he was being punished, tortured?
وكان يتكلم مع الله وهو يعذب.
And he was speaking to Allah and he was being punished.
بلال عبد إلى عباد الله.
And Bilal was only a slave.
ضعيف البنية.
And he had a very weak kind of body.
أسود البشرة.
And his skin was black.
رضي الله عنه وأرضاه.
May Allah be pleased with him.
ولكن يكفيه شرفا.
However, it was sufficient in terms of honor.
أنه مؤذن النبي محمد.
It was sufficient of honor that he was the مؤذن.
بلال هذا كان عبدا وأنتم تعلمون.
And Bilal, he was a slave, as you know.
لأمية بن خلف.
For أمية بن خلف.
فما الذي كان يصبر بلال على العذاب؟
Now who made Bilal patient when he was being tortured?
أقول لك ما هو؟
And should I tell you who it is?
أقسم بالله حبه لله.
It was his love of Allah which made him patient.
كانوا يأتون بالنار.
And they used to.
وبالحديد الملتهب نارا.
And they used to come with hot iron.
ويوضع على رأسه وعلى بطنه.
And it was placed on his head and on his belly.
من أن يرد إلى الكفر.
Such that he apostated.
ولكن بلال كان يقول.
However, Bilal, whenever he was punished, tortured, he would say.
كان يقول.
And he would say.
أحد أحد.
He would say one.
فرد صمد.
That he is unique.
لا والد ولا ولد.
He has no son, no father.
رب السماء والأرض والجبال والشجر.
He is the Lord of the heavens and the earth and the mountains and the trees.
له جبيني قد سجد.
And my forehead has prostrated to him.
يا أمية.
And he used to say, O Umayyah,
افعل ما شئت.
That do whatever you want.
والله لن تنال مني.
And that you will never get from me.
إلا هذا الجسد.
And that you will only take from my body.
الذي سوف يأكله الدود.
And this body which one day the worm.
أما روحي وعقلي.
The worms will eat. As for my soul and my mind.
فلا يصل إليهما إلا الله.
That nobody can reach them except Allah.
هذا هو الحب.
And this is love.
أن تصبر على حبيبك.
And that you should be patient with your Lord. That if Allah He tests you with something, you should be patient. And think about Sumayya. Now she died in front of everybody. And what made her patient during her trials is the love of Allah. And similarly Yasir. And when why did he die? And why did he tolerate this punishment? Because of his love of Allah. And because the love of Allah, it reached his heart. And that the world, it was not anything in his eyes.
عبد الله ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه وارضاه.
And also look at Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه.
كما قلنا في هذه النقطة أن الطريق الموصل إلى حب الله متابعة النبي.
Like I mentioned in this point that the way to earn the love of Allah is to follow the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وعدم مخالفة النبي.
And not to disobey him.
لا في المأكل.
And not in the way you eat.
ولا في الملبس.
Even in the way you wear your clothes.
ولا في أي هيئة من هيئاتك.
Or in anything to do with your life.
انظر إلى أحوالك.
And look at your condition.
انظر إلى ملابسك.
And look at your clothes.
الأمور التي نهى عنها النبي هل تفعلها أم لم تفعلها؟
Look at the things which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he forbade. Do you do them or do you not do them?
هل الأمور التي أمر بها النبي فعلتها أم لم تفعلها؟
And the things which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he told you to do, did you do them or did you not do them?
يجد بعض من الناس إذا ما ذكرناهم بهدي النبي.
There are some people when we remind them about the guidance of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
هذا تشدد.
And they say that this is extreme.
كمثلا نرى بعض من شبابنا.
No.
من بعض من أولادنا.
And we see from some of the youth.
أنه مثلا يحلق شعره حلقة مخالفة.
And that sometimes we see from the youth that they shave parts of their head which is not allowed.
نقول له هذه النبي.
And we say to them, what about the guidance of the Prophet ﷺ?
يلبس أشياء التي تلبسها المرأة. نقول له ليس هذا لا يجوز هذا هذه النبي.
And we see that the youth, some of them, they wear things which only women should wear. And we say.
وآخر يلبس عقدة. نقول له هذا ليس من هذه النبي.
And we see others they wear chains and we say that this is not from the guidance of the Prophet ﷺ.
حبيبي
أخوي
في الله.
That brother in Islam.
هذا ليس تشدد.
And this is not being extreme.
أتريد أن تكون يوم القيامة مع من؟
And that do you want to be? Who do you want to be with on the Day of Judgment?
أو بكل هدوء.
And I say to you very calmly.
الشيخ سوف يهدأ. أنا أهدأ الآن.
And
أكلمك ببطء.
I am now calm and I'm speaking to you slowly.
هل تسمعني؟
And can you hear me?
اسمعني.
Can you hear what I'm saying?
أنت يوم القيامة تريد أن تكون مع من؟
That on the Day of Judgment, who do you want to be with?
مع من؟
With who?
مع من؟
With who?
مع زوجتك.
That with your wife?
الشيخ يقول لا.
And this brother is saying he doesn't want to be with his wife.
هو ذكرني أخي.
And this brother he reminded me.
أنني كنت في محاضرة في مصر.
And that I was giving a lecture in Egypt.
الله يفرج عن مصر كربها رب العالمين وسائر بلاد المسلمين.
And we ask Allah to make things easy in Egypt and in all the Muslim countries.
كنت في محاضرة.
And that I was in one lecture.
وكنت أتكلم عن الحور العين وعن الجنة وعن.
And I was speaking about the women of paradise and about paradise.
والله هذا ما حدث معي ما سمعت عنه.
And this is something which I personally experienced. It's not something which I heard.
فكان في آخر الصفوف رجل.
In the back there was a man.
جالس رجل وفي حالة من الخشوع والبكاء.
And this person, he was listening to the lecture and he was concentrating and he was crying.
ولكن توقفته كلمة.
And however, when he heard a certain word, he stopped in his tracks.
جعلته يقف بين الناس يقول لا يا عم الشيخ.
And
يقول لا لا.
And then when he heard this word, he stood up and said in front of everybody, no.
ما هو هذا الأمر؟
Why did he say no? Do you know why he said no? Do you not want to know why? Because I said that I said on the day of judgment that you and your children, he said me and the kids, no problem. And the problem was the third party. And he said, your wife.
لا.
And then he said, no.
في الدنيا وفي الآخرة عم الشيخ.
He said, you mean in this world and in the hereafter, Sheikh?
هو يظن أنه يدخل الجنة مع زوجته التي هي في الدنيا.
And he's thinking that he will go to paradise with the wife in this from the dunya.
على شكلها وعلى مشاكلها في الدنيا.
In her current appearance and with all the problems he has with her in this world. And his wife was making lots of problems for him. And he thought that when he goes to paradise, the same wife will create problems for him in paradise as well. He said, no, I give you good news. That, say to your wife when you go home. And say to your wife, come here.
سمعت الشيخ اليوم.
And that I heard the Sheikh say.
يقول عنك إذا ما دخلت الجنة إن شاء الله لو دخلت الجنة.
And he say to his wife that if you enter paradise.
أنك تكونين أجمل من الحور العين.
That you will be even more beautiful than the women of paradise.
والله العظيم هذا كلام النبي.
And I swear by Allah that this is the statement of the Prophet.
أن المرأة المؤمنة الصالحة.
And that the righteous, pious woman.
الصوامة القوامة.
That the one who fasts and prays at night.
تكون أجمل من الحور العين.
And that she will be more beautiful than the women of paradise.
ومن الحور العين.
And what are the women of paradise?
ومن الحور العين.
And who are the women of paradise?
قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث.
And the Prophet said in a hadith.
لو طلعت بجبهتها بوجهها.
And that if you looked at her face.
ونظرت إلى الدنيا.
And that if this woman of paradise, she looked at the world.
لغابت الشمس ولا أبصر الناس بنورها.
And that the sun, it would go away, and the people, they would be illuminated by her face.
لو أنها تفلت في البحر ريقها.
No, that if she spit in the sea.
وضع في البحر المالح.
If she was put in the salty sea.
يسير عذبا بفضل الله.
That the sea water, it will become sweet.
إذا ما شربت الماء.
That if you drank the water.
انظر وهي تشرب الماء.
If the Hur al-Ain, she drank the water.
ترى الماء وهو ينزل هنا في عنقها.
And you will be able to watch while the water it descends down her throat.
مستعدون للحور العين.
Are you ready for the women of paradise?
مستعدون.
Are you all ready?
عليك بمنهج النبي.
And that you should follow the way of the Prophet.
وهدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And it was the guidance of the Prophet.
فسؤالي.
For my question is.
تريد أن تكون مع من يوم القيامة؟
And that who do you want to be with on the day of judgment?
نعم يا عم الشيخ. أريد أن أكون مع رسول الله.
And that I want to be with the Messenger of Allah.
فسير على منهج رسول الله.
So follow the way of the Prophet.
عبد الله ابن مسعود.
That Abdullah ibn Mas'ud.
انظر إلى حبه لله ولرسوله.
And look at his love for Allah and his messenger.
يضرب لنا المثل الأعلى في اقتدائه برسول الله وطاعته.
He gives us the best example of following the Prophet ﷺ and worship.
ذهب ابن مسعود إلى مسجد رسول الله.
That he went to the mosque of the Prophet ﷺ.
وقبل أن يصل.
And before he arrived.
سمع النبي ابن مسعود سمع النبي من داخل المسجد.
And he heard the voice of the Prophet ﷺ coming from inside the mosque.
متخيل المشهد.
Can you imagine the situation?
متخيل المشهد.
Can you imagine the situation?
النبي في مسجده.
And the Prophet ﷺ is in his mosque.
وابن مسعود خارج المسجد.
And ابن مسعود, he's outside the mosque.
وفي فصل الصيف.
And he is in the season of summer.
والحرارة شديدة جدا جدا.
And it was very very hot.
فابن مسعود سمع النبي.
So Ibn Mas'ud, he heard the Prophet.
وهو خارج المسجد يقول النبي.
And he was outside and he heard the Prophet saying.
يقول لأصحابه اجلسوا.
And he heard the Prophet saying to his companions within the masjid that sit down.
فجلس الصحابة.
So Ibn Mas'ud, he sat down.
الصحابة الذين داخل المسجد.
And the companions within the masjid, they sat down.
وابن مسعود هل يجلس أم لا يجلس؟
Did Ibn Mas'ud sit down or did he not sit down?
يجلس ولا لا يجلس؟
Did he sit down?
الخطاب ليس له.
And he was not even being addressed.
ليس من المعقول أن تقول لولدك هنا اجلس فالذي خارج البيت يجلس.
It's not something reasonable that you say to your son within the house, sit down, and the person outside he sits down.
ولكن ابن مسعود.
However, Ibn Mas'ud.
في مكانه وقف ثم جلس.
Ibn Mas'ud in his place outside the masjid, he immediately sat down.
وبدأ النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديثه يتحدث مع الصحابة ويتكلم مع الصحابة.
And then Ibn Mas'ud, he started to address the companions.
وابن مسعود في الطريق جالس.
And Ibn Mas'ud, he was on his way to the mosque and he was sitting on the ground.
فخرج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he left the masjid. And he found Ibn Mas'ud. And he found Ibn Mas'ud sweating. And his face had become red. And the Prophet ﷺ said to him that, why did you sit down? And look at his obedience to Allah and His Messenger. This is because of his love.
الحب ليس بالأقوال.
And that loving is not just making statements.
إن المحب لمن أحب مطيع.
And that whenever you love someone, you follow them.
إذا قال لك تعالى الفجر لابد أن تذهب إليه.
And that if your person you love, he says to you that come to Fajr, then you must go to Fajr.
أظن لو سألت أخي الشيخ إمام المسجد عن حال الفجر.
That I am sure if I asked the Imam of the mosque about what's the situation like at Fajr.
كيف يكون الحال؟
That what is the situation?
طب أقسم بالله.
That I swear by Allah.
دخلت في أحد البلدان.
That I went to a country.
المسجد.
And the mosque.
في شارع.
And it was in a street.
لو نزلت العمارة فقط التي أمام المسجد لم تلأ المسجد.
No.
لو نزل سكان no. العمارة.
That if the residents of the building they came down.
لم تلأ المسجد.
نعم لم تلأ. That the mosque would have become full.
ولكنني والله ما صلى الإمام إلا أنا وهو.
However, when I went to this masjid in front of this building, that the only people who prayed in this mosque was myself and the Imam.
أين الناس؟
Now, where are the people?
أين حبك للنبي؟
And where is the love of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
طب أسألك سؤال.
And I ask you a question.
وجاوب عليه في نفسي.
And answer the question yourself.
كم فجر صليت في هذا الأسبوع الذي مضى؟
And how many Fajr have you prayed in this week? In the mosque.
جواب.
Now what's the answer?
جواب.
What's the answer?
ممكن واحد جاوب صح؟
Then everybody answered themselves.
هل رضيت عن نفسك؟
Are you happy with yourself?
رضيت عن نفسك؟
Are you happy with yourself?
أظن أن الإجابة.
I think that the answer.
لم تكن ترضيك.
That is an answer which will not please you.
فإن حب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The love of the Prophet that then takes you to the love of Allah is not just measured by statements. So the Prophet said to Ibn Mas'ud that what made you sit down? He said, O Messenger of Allah, I heard you say sit down. For this reason I sat down. And I became frightened. And I should walk one step. I should go backwards. And then I would be accused of having disobeyed Allah and His Messenger. And this is the generation of people who the Prophet ﷺ he raised. So listen with your heart. That listen with your heart, not with your ears. In the battle of Uhud,
لما خالف الصحابة أمر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And when the companions they disobeyed the Prophet ﷺ.
ونزل الرماة من على الجبل.
And that the archers they came down from the mountain.
وكان بداية المعركة كان النصر لرسول الله.
And the beginning of the battle, it looked as though the companions they would win the battle.
ولكن لما خالفوا أمر النبي.
However, when they disobeyed the command of the Prophet ﷺ.
انتصر المشركون.
Then the polytheists they became victorious.
اسمع.
Now listen.
وفر الصحابة.
And the companions they fled.
والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في قلب المعركة.
And the Prophet ﷺ, he was in the middle of the battle.
والتف.
And they were surrounded.
تسعة من الصحابة.
And he was surrounded by nine of the companions.
حول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم دائرة.
And they formed a ring around the Prophet ﷺ.
انظر ويرتفعون إلى أعلى. يقفز الواحد منهم إلى أعلى.
And that they were jumping.
ليأتي السهم في قلبه أو في عينه أو في رأسه ليست هناك مشكلة.
Such that the arrows they would hit the companion in his eye or in his face, and that wasn't a problem.
ولكن الأمر شديد جدا.
However, it was a very difficult situation.
فإذا بامرأة.
And then a woman.
تسمى نسيبة بنت كعب.
And she was called نسيبة بنت كعب.
اسمع نسيبة بنت كعب.
نسيبة بنت كعب.
رأت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم والسهام تأتي إليه من كل مكان.
And that she saw the Prophet ﷺ under attack from arrows from every direction.
فإذا بها تجري إلى رسول الله.
So she ran to the Messenger of Allah.
وتعطي ظهرها لرسول الله مع الذين قد وقفوا مع رسول الله.
And she put her back towards the enemy to protect the Prophet.
وتقفز إلى أعلى.
And she started to jump.
ليأتي السهم في عينها.
Such that the arrow could hit.
أو في كتفها.
Or could hit her in the eye or in the shoulder.
وتصرخ بأعلى صوتها.
And she was screaming with a loud voice.
وتقول.
And she was saying.
فداك أبي وأمي يا رسول الله.
Say may my mother and father be sacrificed for you, O Messenger of Allah.
فجاء عقبة بن أبي معيط هذا الكافر.
And one of the kafirs, he came.
فإذا بسهم بسيفه.
And with his sword.
يضرب نسيبة في كتفها هنا.
And she cut her hand off.
فنزل
her arm off. And her arm fell off.
بقطعة اللحم التي من الكتف.
And the piece of flesh from her shoulder.
إلى الأرض.
Until her arm it fell off.
هل تركت رسول الله هي؟
And did she abandon the Prophet ﷺ?
اسمع أنا ما أكلمك عن قصص.
And I'm not just saying to you a story.
بل أنا أكلمك عن واقع حياة.
I'm telling you about something which really happened.
أكلمك عن رجال ولو كانوا نساء.
And I'm telling you about men, even a woman.
فلما نزل ذراعها.
And when her hand fell off at her feet.
وهي تقفز بذراع واحد.
And then she was jumping up with only one arm.
فأتعبها هذا الذراع.
And this piece of flesh.
فوضعت هذا الذراع تحت قدمها.
And this piece of flesh that was hanging. She placed it under her foot.
ثم قفزت إلى أعلى لتفصل الذراع عن جسدها.
And then she jumped up such that her arm it would be separate from her body.
فرآها النبي.
So the Prophet ﷺ saw her.
فقال نسيبة.
And he called her.
سليني. اسأليني الآن.
He said to her that ask me now.
ماذا تريدين مني الآن.
That what do you want from me now.
سليني يا نسيبة ما شئت.
And he said that ask me whatever you want.
قال طلب واحد.
She said I only want one thing.
أمر واحد.
I only want one thing.
أن أكون رفيقتك في الجنة.
That I want to be with you in paradise.
فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لك ذلك.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to her that you will have that.
فمتابعة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So following the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
والاقتداء برسول الله.
And following him.
من أكبر الأمور الموصلة إلى.
And this is from the greatest.
أكون ممن أحبهم الله رب العالمين.
And it is from the greatest things such that you are with the person who you love.
والأمر الأخير.
And the final thing I want you to say.
أن تتصف بالصفات التي يحبها الله.
And that you should describe yourself with those things, or you should act with those things which Allah He loves.
ذكر الله صفات في القرآن.
And that Allah He has mentioned descriptions in the Quran.
إن تحققت فيك.
That if you do these things.
كنت ممن أحبهم الله.
Then you will be from those people who Allah loves.
حققت فيك صفة من تلك الصفات.
And that one of the descriptions which Allah loves is in you.
اسمع.
Listen.
قال الله رب العالمين.
And Allah Lord of the worlds, He says.
الذين يحبهم.
And He says about those who love Him.
إن الله يحب.
That Allah He loves.
إن الله يحب التوابين ويحب
المتطهرين. That Allah He loves those who repent again and again and who purify themselves.
إن الله يحب الصابرين.
And Allah He loves those who are patient.
والله يحب المحسنين.
And Allah loves those who are kind.
والله يحب المتوكلين.
And Allah loves those who depend upon Him.
إن الله يحب الذين يجاهدون في سبيله.
And Allah loves those who fight in His way.
صفا كأنهم بنيان مرصوص.
They fight in rows as though they are one body.
اسمع قال الله رب العالمين.
And listen, Allah Lord of the worlds, He says.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا.
That all you who believe.
من يرتد منكم عن دينه.
That whoever turns away from his religion.
فسوف يأتي الله بقوم.
That Allah He will come with another people.
اسمع يحبهم ويحبون.
That will come with the people who. He loves them and they love him.
يحبهم ويحبون.
That he loves them and they love him.
صفاتهم يا رب.
And what is their description?
أذلاء على المؤمنين.
That they are humble with the believers.
اسمع أعزاء على الكافرين.
And they are above the disbelievers, and that they fight in the way of Allah, and they don't care about people blaming them. And Allah, He loves those who are pious. And these are the descriptions that if these descriptions they apply to you, if they apply to you, then you have arrived at the love of Allah. And I wanted to finish this lecture that if you arrive,
that
how do I know and how do you know that you are from those who Allah loves? And I say to you, and it is authentically reported that the Prophet said that whenever Allah He loves His slave, whenever Allah He loves a slave, that Allah calls, O Jibreel, that, oh, yeah, O Jibreel, I love such and such a person. May Allah make us from this person. That I love such and such a person. So, O Jibreel, love this person. I swear by Allah. That is it not sufficient that only Allah He loves you? Is this enough? This is enough. And listen to the excellence. And listen to the favor. And the gift. That, O Jibreel, I love him. And then he will say to Jibreel, so make sure you love him. And then Jibreel will love him. Is this enough? Is this the end? No, this is not the end.
And listen.
And then Jibreel, he will call. And then he will say to all
people,
O angels of the most merciful, that Allah, He loves such and such. Oh, he loves such and such female. That can you imagine this great favor, this honor? That you are of those who Allah loves and Jibreel loves. And the angels love. Is this not enough? That I have not finished.
نعم يا أحباب هل تتخيل هذه الأمور؟
Can you imagine these things?
هل ما زلت أنك مصر أن تعصي الجبار؟
That are you still determined to disobey Allah?
هل أنت مصر على أن تكون بعيدا عن الله؟
Are you going to carry on being distant from Allah?
هل أنت مصر على أن تكون على معصية؟
Are you going to carry on disobeying Allah?
هل ما زلت أنك تريد أن تقصر في الصلوات؟
Are you still going to be deficient in your prayers?
هل ما زلت أن تكون مقصر في صلاة الفجر؟
Are you still going to be deficient in your Fajr prayer?
في ذمتك للوالدين؟
Are you still going to be deficient in being good to your parents and being good to your relatives and in spreading tales and in lying and in hating people? So Jibreel will call out to the angels that Allah loves such and such, so love him. Then the angels, they will love him. And the angels, they never disobey Allah and they always do as they are commanded. And that the angels, they didn't love you for any kind of personal benefit. And that the angels, they did not love you out of need for wealth or for 100 pounds or even for euros or for dollars, or because you are strong or because you are rich. And the angels, they only love you because Allah loves you. And then listen. And then Allah places the acceptance of that person that is loved in the earth. And that whenever people sit with this person who Allah loves, and then you will always find somebody who says, you will always find somebody who says about this person, I love you for the sake of Allah. Even though this person who is saying he loves you, you don't even know him. And you feel as though your heart is inclined towards him. And that your love has struck his heart. And that for this person who is loved by Allah, things are easy for him. and that Allah makes things easy for him, and that he makes him feel tranquil and calm, and he lives and he dies in the worship of Allah. And then when the day of judgment comes, and then he takes shade under the throne of Allah, and he enters paradise, and he is married from the women of paradise, and Allah, he honors him with the favor of looking at the face of Allah. And listen to this last word. And Allah, he says to this person he loves in paradise,
that,
oh my slaves, and that, are you happy with me? That, are you happy with me? And they will say, our Lord. And then, how can we not be pleased with you? That you have entered us into paradise. And that you have saved us from the hellfire. And then Allah, he will say to them, that, ask me. That, did you not make our faces white? And that, did you not make us into paradise? That Allah will just say, just ask me. That, ask me.
لما تسمع عن إنسان وتحبه ولم تراه.
And that whenever you hear about a person you love and you have not seen him.
كل ما يشغلك ما هو.
That the only thing which concerns you is what.
كل ما يشغلك ما هو.
What is the thing which concerns you? What is it?
How does he look?
ما منظره.
نعم. أن تنظر إليه.
And that you want to see him.
فأهل الجنة يقول ربنا.
And that the people of paradise, they will say, our Lord.
في صوت واحد ربنا.
They will all say in one voice.
لنا طلب واحد.
That we all have only one wish.
ربنا أرنا وجهك ننظر إليه.
That show us your face such that we may see it.
ربنا أرنا وجهك.
That show us your face.
وجه الكريم الكبير.
That your noble face.
وجه ملك الملوك جل جلاله يا عباد الله.
The face of the King of all kings.
فيكشف الله لهم الحجب.
And then Allah, he will unveil his face.
فينظرون إليه جل جلاله.
And then the people, they will look at his face.
فلولا أن الله تبارك وتعالى.
And if Allah.
كتب عليهم ألا يموتوا.
And if Allah, he made for them such that they do not die.
لماتوا من صبحات وجهه جل جلاله.
And that they die from the sight of Allah's face. And that they, oh brothers, that the world, it has no value. That I say to you, that protect that which Allah loves. And keep away from those things which are hated by Allah. And he is the one, because he is the one who created you and gave you. And so beware of doing something which Allah hates. And that if Allah decrees for us to meet again, and that maybe we will speak about the things which Allah hates, so don't do them. However, and that be in a place which Allah, he loves to see you in.
And keep, عن المكان الذي لا يحب أن يراك الله فيه.
And stay away from those places which Allah, he does not like to see you in these places.
افعل ما أمر.
And do that which you are commanded.
وانتهي عما نهى.
And don't do that which you have been forbade from.
ممن أحبهم الله.
And be with those people who Allah loves.
ويقول الله رب العالمين.
And Allah, Lord of the worlds, he says.
قل الحمد لله وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى.
Say all praises to Allah and.
الله خير أما يشركون.
Which is better, Allah or those things which they associate with Allah?
أمن خلق السماوات والأرض وأنزل من السماء.
Isn't the one who created the heavens and the earth?
وأنزل لكم من السماء.
And he is the one who brought down the rain, and we gave. And he sent down rain, and then the plants came, and you could never have done this yourself.
أَإِلَهٌ مَعَ اللَّهِ.
true God are worthy of worship apart from Allah.
بل هم قوم يعدلون.
However, there are people who turn away.
أمن جعل الأرض قرارا.
The one who has made the earth as a place of rest. And he made in this earth seas and oceans. And he made in them mountains. And he made in them mountains. And he blessed them. Is there anyone worthy of worship alongside Allah?
بل أكثرهم لا يعلمون أمن يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه
And who is the one who removes the difficulty from the one who is in difficulty
ويكشف السوء ويجعلكم خلفاء الأرض
And who removes the difficulty and makes you inheritors of the earth Is there anyone worthy of worship apart from Allah? Yet little do you remember. That if we tasted the sweetness of the Quran, and we would have known the signs of love and the reality of love. So increase in the remembrance of Allah. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he said.
إن الله يحب من عباده
And Allah he loves from his slaves
أن يموت الإنسان وقلبه ولسانه
And he loves that his slaves should die and his tongue
رضي بذكر الله رب العالمين
is busy in the remembrance of Allah
جزاكم الله خيرا
May Allah reward you
وأنا والله في غاية السعادة
And I am extremely happy
حيث أنني رأيت هذه الوجوه الطيبة
And I saw these bright faces
وأسأل الله كما جمعنا في هذا المكان الطيب
And we ask Allah just as He gathered us in this place
أن يجمعنا مع سيدنا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الفردوس
And He gathers us in the highest paradise in the company of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
وأولادنا وأزواجنا
And also with our wives and with our children
الله عز وجل ألا يخرجكم من بيته
And we ask Allah that He does not make us leave this place except that He has met all our needs and He has made matters easy for us and He has made us feel tranquil and calm and He has blessed us in our wealth and our children.
جزاكم الله خيرا والحمد لله رب العالمين.
الحمد لله رب العالمين.